हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज के आर टी आर्ट्स बी एच कॉमर्स एंड एम साइंस के डी एच एम कॉलेज नासिक डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स. आर क्लासेज एस वाई बी कॉम. वी आर स्टडिंग द 2019 सी बी सी एस पैटर्न. सब्जेक्ट इज कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग एंड एप्लीकेशन. आर सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 236L एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर टू डिस्कस टूडे इज वेब बेस्ट एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट यूजिंग HTML. लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ. आई एम मिस्टर सतीश केदाराधार राव. I'll be teaching you the topic web-based application development HTML. Let us take the overview of HTML. Dear students, in our previous lessons we have discussed about internet. We had studied that the backbone of internet is web pages, and these web pages are written using HTML. So today we are going to learn the overview of HTML. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It stands for Hypertext Markup Language. So full form of HTML is Hypertext Markup Language, and it is the most widely used language to write the web pages. Now let us understand these words one by one. What do you mean by hypertext? Hypertext refers to the way in which web pages and HTML documents are linked together. Thus, the link available on a web page is called as hypertext. Dear students, you are browsing through web pages on internet. You are seeing certain text which are being marked. Like, see, I'll give you an example over here. See this particular example here. You could see that this text is called as hypertext. This text is called as hypertext. This text is called as hypertext. So whatever text you could see, this text which is marked with a finger, a raised finger and a hand, that particular text is identified as a hypertext. So when you click onto this hypertext, it takes you to the next session. And thus we are going to understand that this particular link is called as hyperlink, and the text is called as hypertext. You could observe here that when I clicked onto this link, this text has a link. So this link is identified with this particular hand symbol, which you could see here. A raised finger is there. When you click it, it takes you to some another destination or some another location. So this text, which takes you to that particular location, is called as hypertext, and the link is called as hyperlink. So I hope the concept of hypertext is very clear with you now. So hypertext refers to the way in which web pages or documents are linked together. Thus, the link available on a web page is called as hypertext. Then the second thing that you have to understand is about markup language. As its name suggests, HTML is a markup language, which means you use HTML to simply mark up a text document with tags that tells a web browser how to structure it to display. Remember here what this particular para reads. This para reads that the text that you are going to mark up, which you are going to mark up within the tag, that particular text is going to be markup. Let us take this example here. You could see here that I have to make this text into bigger heading. So I am marking it within this particular tag. So it is within this H1. So opening H1 and closing H1. So whatever is enclosed between this H1 and this /H1, this is marked. That we are telling the browser that, Mr. Browser, please convert this text into the style of H1. So this particular aspect of HTML is called as markup. So we are assigning this particular effects to those text using markup languages. So remember, students, here we are using HTML to create web pages. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, आता आपण जे इंग्रजीमध्ये ऐकलं ते एच टी एम एलच्या संदर्भामध्ये जे ऐकलं आपण त्याच्यामध्ये एच टी एम एल शब्दाचा अर्थ होतो हायपर टेक्स्ट मार्कअप लँग्वेज. आता आपण ह्या दोन्ही शब्दांचा ह्या चार शब्दांचा अर्थ समजून घेऊया. साधारणपणे एच टी एम एल नंतर हायपर टेक्स्ट मार्कअप लँग्वेज. एच टी एम एल ही इंटरनेटवर आपण वर्ल्ड वाईड वेबच्या सेवा वापरून जे वेब पेजेस बघतो ती वेब पेजेस तयार करण्यासाठी आपल्याला एच टी एम एलचा वापर करावा लागतो. एच टी एम एलचं पूर्ण रूप आहे हायपर टेक्स्ट मार्कअप लँग्वेज. आता याच्यातले जे तीन शब्द आहे आपण त्यांचा अर्थ समजून घेऊया. हायपर टेक्स्ट, हायपर टेक्स्ट, हायपर म्हणजे एका ठिकाणून दुसऱ्या ठिकाणी आपल्याला घेऊन जाणारं, टेक्स्ट म्हणजे शब्द अक्षर. इथे मी तुम्हाला अगोदर एक्झाम्पल जे दाखवलं होतं की हे जे तुम्हाला दिसत आहेत जिथे हा हाताचं चिन्ह ज्यावेळेस येतं बोटवरती केलेलं, तो जो टेक्स्ट आहे ती जी अक्षरं आहेत ते जे शब्द आहेत ते शब्द हे बघा इथे तुम्हाला दिसत आहे. त्याच्यानंतर इथे दिसत आहे का बघा, इथे तुम्हाला ते दिसत नाही पण वरती गेलं तर इथे दिसेल. म्हणजेच काय, ज्यावेळेस ते बोटाचं चिन्ह येतं बघा खाली पण मी तुम्हाला उदाहरण दाखवतो, इथे बोटाचं चिन्ह दिसतं, इथे बोटाचं चिन्ह लागलेच त्याच्या खाली रेष येते. म्हणजे ही हायपरलिंक आहे आपल्याला लागलीच व्हिज्युअली दृश्य स्वरूपात समजायला येतं. इथे पण बघा ही हायपरलिंक आहे आणि जी साधारण टेक्स्ट आहे ते तुमचं हे बघा हे असं साधारण टेक्स्ट आहे की ज्याला क्लिक केल्याने काही होत नाही, फक्त सिलेक्ट होतं. पण याला क्लिक केलं तर हे जे टेक्स्ट आहे आपण ज्याला लिंक केलेलं आहे त्या डॉक्युमेंटकडे आपल्याला घेऊन जात असतं. तर याच्या अगोदर मी याची चर्चा तुम्हाला इंग्रजीमध्ये केलीच होती, तर तुम्हाला ह्या गोष्टी समजल्याच असतील की हायपर टेक्स्ट म्हणजे काय. आता पुढची गोष्ट आहे मार्कअप लँग्वेज. मार्कअप, मार्कअप म्हणजे काय, चिन्हित करणे. म्हणजेच ही जी भाषा आहे इंटरनेटवर वेब पेजेस तयार करण्याची जी भाषा आहे ती प्रत्येक इफेक्टला चिन्हित करत असते. इथे बघा तुम्ही सगळे तुम्हाला वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे चिन्ह दिसतील, एच टी एम एल, हेड, टायटल, बॉडी वगैरे वगैरे. तर आपण एक साधारणपणे एक छोटंसं वेब पेज कसं तयार करायचं ते इथे समजून घ्या. डिअर स्टुडंट्स, नाव वी आर गोईंग टू अंडरस्टँड दॅट हाऊ टू क्रिएट अ वेब पेज. सो टू क्रिएट अ वेब पेज, डिअर स्टुडंट्स, लेट अस अंडरस्टँड दॅट वॉट आर द मिनिमम बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट्स टू राईट अ वेब पेज. यू शूड हॅव युअर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स ऑन युअर कम्प्युटर. नॉर्मली देर आर टू टाईप्स ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स, यू कॅन हॅव विंडोज, यू कॅन हॅव उबंटू, इवन Macintosh is there, but since we are familiar with Windows, so I'm going to discuss about Windows and Ubuntu operating system. In Windows, you need to have a text editor and a browser. See carefully, I'm marking it here, this text editor. The default text editor that is available with your computer of Windows is Notepad, and the default browser available is Microsoft Edge. So these are the two basic necessities that you should have to have a web page with you. To develop a web page, to write a web page, you should have Notepad and a browser. Now if suppose you are not able to see this Notepad, the simple thing that you could do is come here onto the search option. Into search option, type Notepad. Notepad, and just say click here, it will open a Notepad window for you and start typing your program over here, and then you are going to have a browser into which you are going to execute the program. If it is Ubuntu operating system, you can use Mozilla Firefox, the default browser and its default text editor. So I'm going to explain you the simple program of HTML. What are its components? So let us understand that what are these contents of your web page. So the very first thing that you could see here is doctype. This is our program. This is our basic program, and this is its explanation that what is the sentence stands for or what is that particular thing it stands for. So what is this doc type HTML? With this tag, we let the browser know that this document is of the type HTML and its version is 5. Then HTML. This tag encloses the complete HTML document and mainly comprises of document header, which is represented by head and slash head, and document body, which is represented by body slash body. So as I told you earlier, that HTML is made up of two sections, head and body. So this is your head and this is your body. So all these components, they are enclosed between this opening HTML and this closing HTML. Then the next statement is head. Here this head is, this tag represents the document's header, which can be kept other HTML tags like title, link and etc. So again, header is a container tag which can contain furthermore tags into it. So further tags can be nested into header similar to HTML. So what is it? It can have title, link, style and all other components which can be part of head. Then the next is your title. This title tag is used inside the head tag and it is used to mention the document title. Here you could see that this is document title. It has been enclosed between this opening title and this closing title tag. See, it is something like this. Can you see here on the top of my mouse movement? This file has been saved with the name HTML intro of program. So if you want the name of this document, of your HTML document, to appear on this title bar of your browser, then you should put it into this title tag. So title, this is document title slash title. And this slash head, it is the closing heading tag. Next is the body. Now body, this tag represents the document's body, which keeps other HTML tags like H1, div, paragraph and etc. So these are the components of your body tag, which we are going to discuss in our further lectures. For the time being, just understand that your HTML document is made up of two parts, head and body. Head contains the title and the other components such as link, style and etc. Whereas the body contains the H1, div, para and other components. Here you could see that this is H1 tag is the header tag. There are different levels of heading tags which we are going to study in our future lectures. So whatever has been defined here in this body section, this is going to appear in the body of your browser window. Whereas this title is going to appear in the title bar of your browser window. Here your document finishes, that is why you have to put here closing body tag. See, any tag, if it is marked with a front slash, it means that the effect of that tag has to be stopped there. We mark it up. We tell the browser that the effect of the particular tag should finish over here. So it is marked with front slash. Here my HTML document finishes, so closing HTML document. So these are the things that you are going to understand in this particular topic of HTML.